Hello guys, welcome to my channel. I would like to inform you that I have published my mnemonics books. To know more about these books, kindly visit my website www.medinas.com. Today we will discuss about herpes zoster infection. It is caused by varicella zoster virus, which is a DNA virus. Infection is first manifested as chickenpox, which is an exanthematous fever. That means fever is associated with skin rashes. After attack of chickenpox, varicella zoster virus remain latent in the dorsal root ganglion of spinal nerves. Here you can see the spinal cord section. Here is anterior horn and here is posterior horn. This portion is dorsal root ganglion and here is the latent viruses. Extramedullary ganglion of cranial nerves are also affected, commonly V1, C3, T5, L1 and L2. Reactivation produces herpes zoster infection, which is commonly called shingles, which means belt-like. Now let's talk about the risk factors. Old people, mostly who are more than 50 years old, are always vulnerable to this infection. Other risk factors are immunosuppression, like HIV infection, leukemia, lymphoma, immunosuppressive drug therapy, or organ transplant. Transmission is by respiratory route usually, and incubation period is 2 to 3 weeks. Now let's discuss about the clinical features. Initially, you can find some prodromal signs and symptoms which last for 2 to 4 days, like low-grade fever, malaise, shooting pain, paresthesia, burning and tenderness along the cords of knob. Then some unilateral multiple dewdrop-like vesicles appeared on erythematous base showing single dermatome involvement. Those vesicles turns cloudy and fistula and finally burst and heal within 2 to 4 weeks. Most frequently involved dermatome is thoracic and lumbar dermatomes. Ophthalmic division of trigeminal nerve affects 15 to 20 times more commonly than maxillary and mandibular division. Ophthalmic division involvement affects the upper eyelid and forehead and scalp. Maxillary division affects mid-face, upper lip and palatal area. And mandibular division affects lower face, lower lip, mandibular gingiva and tongue. Herpes zoster of geniculate ganglion is known as Ramsey-Hunt syndrome, which is rare and it causes Bell's palsy, unilateral vesicles on external ear, palate, ovula and anterior tongue area. Lesions commonly heal with scarring and hypopigmentation. Serious and occasional side effects in V1 or ophthalmic division involvement is acute retinal necrosis, corneal scarring, and blindness. Sometimes pain lingers for 120 days, which is called post-herpetic neuralgia. Intraorally, multiple ulcerative, extremely painful lesions are seen unilaterally, which cause severe odontalgia or toothache, and then exfoliation of tooth, osteonecrosis, pulpal necrosis, and internal root resorption. Here, I would like to mention an interesting point that herpes zoster sometimes appears without typical vesicular eruption. Patient present only with unilateral burning pain sensation. It is really difficult to diagnose. This special form is called herpes sine herpes. Sine means without. Sometimes ciliary ganglion involvement may cause argyle Robertson pupil. Now let's discuss about the lab findings. Multinucleated giant cell with ballooning degeneration of nucleus and intranuclear eosinophilic inclusion bodies can be seen. Fluorescent antibody stain using fluorescent conjugated monoclonal antibodies are more reliable. Antibody titer is rarely necessary except in case of herpes sine eruption. PCR and real-time PCR is also helpful. Now some differential diagnosis. Differential diagnosis can be herpes simplex virus infection, pemphigus and pemphigoid, then necrotizing ulcerative periodontitis and pulpitis. Now treatment part. Adequate antiviral drug should be administered ideally within 72 hours of onset of the disease. It is essential to reduce the pain, duration and future post-herpetic neuralgia. You can give acyclovir 800 mg 5 times a day for 7 days. Otherwise, valacyclovir 1000 mg thrice a day for 7 days or famcyclovir 500 mg thrice a day for 7 days. In the past, corticosteroid like prednisone 40 to 60 mg for 1 to 2 weeks were prescribed to prevent post-herpetic neuralgia in older individual, but it is controversial. That's all guys. If you have enjoyed this video, please like, comment and share, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.